One of the big issues after we saw Treasury International capital flows yesterday is, with all this growing supply and attention to deficits, rates either have to go higher, supply is going to be an issue, who's going to buy it? What are your thoughts?
We do think there's supply pressure, and that's going to push yields higher, all else being equal. You know, we have the T-bills that were keep rolling. We're adding to the deficit. And then, like you said, we're seeing some of the big buyers step out of the market. You've seen some of the foreign buyers step back. Corporations who used to be big buyers aren't buying in the same way. So I think there's going to be some pressure on yields.
You know, and that makes perfect sense. The problem is, whether you go back and look at Graham Rubin deficits in the 80s, sometimes markets have counterintuitive moves. We see that there was an awful lot of buying on the Treasury International capital flows, just not the names we're used to. So I would phrase it this way. Will some of that actually end up helping the yield curve? I'll tell you why. Right now, a six-month bill gets around 240. A year bill gets 256. All things being equal, many say what's going to keep rates from going too high is buying by investors. But mostly they're probably going to buy the short end. Is that going to make long end rates move higher in tandem with some of the issues of supply?
Yeah, again, I think we need to see some growth. One thing that's helped, you know, the back end of yields right now has been a little bit of global growth concern and stock markets, right? As stock markets went down, we finally caught a bid to bonds. I think all else being equal, again, people are going to gravitate towards, why not invest in 2 years to pick up 2.5%? You can kind of reallocate your portfolio, de-risk, and still get a decent amount of income. So I think that's a trend we will see, which should push to steeper curves.
Gotcha. Now, when it comes to, you know, corporates and where they are on the investment grade, triple Bs, for example, or move to the more extreme and high yield, we all know that the likes of the Bank of Japan and the European Central Bank have been helping corporate securities globally because they've been purchasing them. But in the end, I continue to say, what's the juicy rates in better credits like sovereigns and T-bills, ultimately, aren't corporations going to have an issue trying to move some of this paper?
I think over time they could. I think people have been a little bit too concerned about corporate credit risk. I think when you go and talk to the corporations, they're very well managed. They understand what they need to be. And what we should start seeing now, though, is there's been a lot of talk about deleveraging, a lot of talk about controlling the balance sheet. That hasn't turned into action. Now that yields are higher, now that there's more competition for that bond money, I think corporations are going to have to deliver on that. You're going to see a bit of divergence. Those companies that perform, as said, have great earnings. There are going to be no problems in their credit spreads. They can even go tighter on the longer end. Those who don't follow through, those who see leverage increasing, those who don't perform on the earnings side, I think there will be a real separation and you're going to get a divergence. So you're going to have to be right on your credit picks. It's not just going to be student body left, student body right. You have to be right. But as a whole, I'm comfortable with credit spreads.